This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, this is our first video on graphing a secant function, and we are going to use the same techniques we used to graph y equals the cosecant of x. So make sure you've seen the videos on graphing y equals cosecant of x, and of course, to do that, you needed to know how to graph the y equals sine of x. So, if we want to graph y equals secant of x, we have to remember that secant is the reciprocal of the cosine. So that's the same thing as 1 over cosine of x. So you do have to know how to graph y equals the cosine of x to use this technique, which is to graph y equals cosine of x using dotted lines and then take the reciprocal of each y coordinate to graph the y coordinates for cosecant. All right, so let's do that. We're going to try to graph y equals the secant of x. And so we're going to begin by graphing y equals the cosecant of x. All right, so remember the period for cosine is 2 pi, if it's just the cosine of x. And the difference between graphing sine and cosine is the first order pair is 0, 1, because when you put in 0 for x, y is 1. So it starts up here. And then it goes down, comes back up, and it ends here. Now, I always have trouble graphing this just one period. It kind of bothers me because it's hard to see that it's a full period. I like to kind of continue it over here. So that's up to you. That's why I usually do two periods at least, so you could really see the full period. But this is 2 periods of pi. I'm sorry, 2 periods of the cosine. All right, next we need to find our asymptotes. Everywhere that the graph goes through the x-axis, we would be trying to take the reciprocal of 0, which is undefined. So I need to draw some asymptotes through the places it crosses the x-axis. So this is a little bit trickier than the cosecant, because the first place it goes through is not 0 and then pi and then 2 pi. You have to know what these values are right here. This is pi over 2, remember? The x coordinate here, this is pi over 2. This is pi, and this is 3 pi over 2. And so, to figure out the asymptotes, whatever the first asymptote is, see what you have to add to get to the next asymptote. So if you start at pi over 2, you have to add how much to get to 3 pi over 2. That's the difference if you can't figure that out. It's pi units. It's really half of whatever the period is. That's another way. So one thing, to get the asymptote, maybe that's an easier way to do that. To get the vertical asymptote, start at 1. Asymptote and add a multiple of half the period. All right, so I'm just going to write those down right now while I'm thinking about it. For the secant, so far we have that the period was 2 pi. So the vertical asymptotes, you take one of the vertical asymptotes. It's going to be written as x equals something, remember, because it's a vertical line. So I'm going to start at pi over 2, but you could start at 3 pi over 2, pi over 2. And then you're going to add a multiple of half the period. Okay, so the period's 2 pi. Half of the period is just pi. But it's a multiple of it. So it's pi k, where k is an element of the integers. I'm going to make this purple so we can see that's part of our answer here. Here we go. All right, so we've got our vertical asymptotes, and this is how we could describe them. Almost done. Let's graph it. That was the main thing. How are we going to graph y equals the secant of x? All right, so remember the maximums of the cosine are the minimums for the secant. So these are just guidelines. So you think of the asymptotes as guidelines. So here we go. If I kept going, that would go up over there. Here's another one going down here. So if I went a little bit further over and I made, it's up to you, you know how many, if I'd have kept on going, you know, you could see that it keeps going on and on and on. Remember, these are not parabolas. So there we have the graph in purple of y equals secant of x. Make sure you dot, if you're going to use this technique, don't put a solid line for the cosine. We've got the period. We've got the vertical asymptotes. All we have left to do is state what the range is. All right, what's the range? Well, it goes down forever, so negative infinity goes up to negative 1 and then begins at 1 again and goes to infinity. And this is the simplest secant function. We'll do ones where we have a coefficient in front or a different period on subsequent videos. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.